it'll be for 14 years. He and I started together down in them honky tonks in South Alabama about 14 years ago. And if you don't believe it, we got scars to prove it. Good boy, though. I tell you something, though. Every place we go play, the girls come to me and they want to know if this boy has got one of these Tonys or Lilts or Richard Hudnuts or something like that, because his hair is so curly. Well, girl, it's all his, but it ain't natural curly, I tell you. We left the United States and went over into Arkansas last year and played for a couple of days. We was booked there 2 days, and we got caught in Ball Knob in a storm. They had a flood. Brother, I'd like to wash that whole place off. Me and the rest of the boys sitting up on top of this little hotel trying to keep him getting drowned, but ambitious, you know. He'd go down and look around, see the town. He got out and got wet, and that head wore up that way. It's been that way ever since. He's a good boy, though. He comes from a little town down in New Brockton, Alabama, called New Brockton. In fact, they thought so much of him, he run for mayor down there last year. He's there this year, he's going to run for the city limits, and I'm hoping he makes it. They sure get scarce, these good steel men. This boy's sort of like my right arm to me. Don Helm, there he is. Take him up. Well, I want you to meet the child of the outfit now. He ain't been here too long. He's been with us about 5 years. I like to talk about him, but his ears turn red all up. He looks like a neon sign or something. He's a good boy, though. Everything he steals, he mails it straight home to his mama. He don't waste no time. Man, we had him out in Texas last week. We played, where do we play? Corpus Christi, Beaumont, Houston, Memphis. That's where it was. We played 2 days in Houston. He got married the weekend before we left. And he left and lost his mind. I ain't never seen nobody go through what he went through. Walk up down the hall of that hotel and just wring his hands and cry, pull his hair. I had to pay for 4 or 5 walls he butted his head through. I called him in the room. I said, now look, Junior, I said, we got to talk this thing over. I said, this button, these holes in these walls is getting too expensive. I said, now you sit down and get on that phone and call her up and talk to her and you'll feel better. He said, I'd do that, but he said, I just can't afford it. I said, why can't you afford it? He says, you don't pay me that much money. I said, well, right, sure. He said, I just don't even feel like going to the post office. I said, well, you write it and I'll mail it. Boy, he sat down and he composed her a letter I wish you could have seen. It looked like one of these summer deluxe editions of a Citizen Old Buck catalog. I started at the door of that thing. He said, whoa, he said, I ain't through. I just thought of something. I brought it back and down to the bottom of the last page. He put, P.S., darling, I'm sending you a check for 1,000 hugs and kisses. Now, that really done the boy good, I guarantee you. I carried that bundle on down to the post office, and they charged me $9.67 to mail it to Nashville. But it was worth every penny of it. He had more vim, vigor, and vitality than the whole bunch did for the next about 4 days, I reckon it was. He ain't felt too good since Friday morning. We was in the Rise Hotel there in Houston, Texas. All of us live in the same room. We can't afford a room apiece. That cost too much. We laying in there in the bellboy was kicking on the door, and we all jump up in our nightshirts to see what's going on. We got telegrams of Jerry Rivers. And he gets the telegram. We all peeping over his shoulder to see what it is. It's from his wife. If I'd have been heard, we're going to wire him no more than that. I wouldn't wire him nothing at all. All she said was, thanks, darling, for the check. Said the ice man cashed it this morning. boys make him welcome. His name is Jerry. Sometimes we call him Burrhead Rivers. There he is. I had a young man that we borrowed from Lou and his outfit that is one of the finest bass players that we've run into in a long time. After he about the first one we met in about the last 6 months that could play as bad as we could or as good as we could, one of the two, I don't know which, but anyhow, he stays with us. That's one thing. We played the West Coast for 3 weeks and we ain't found one yet that could stay with us. He either left us or we left him, one of the two. Who's that you're going to get married to? Laura? Laura? Tubby wants me to sing you a pretty song. Because he is figuring on engaging your hand in marriage. Next week? Next week? Next Sunday. Well, son, a lot of things I could tell you, but it wouldn't do you no good. I'll never forget the morning I started getting married. Old man called me in the back room. He had a double barrel shotgun, had both barrels cocked. He said, "Boy," he said, "I'm fixing to kill you." I said, "For what?" He said, "You fixing to get married, ain't you?" I said, "Yeah." I said, "You ain't gonna kill me on my wedding day, are you?" He said, "Yes, sir." I said, "I'm gonna blow you in two right now." I said, "Why?" He said, "Well," he said, "if I kill you now," he says, "you'll die quick." He says, "If I let you get married, you'll sort of ooze out." This boy does. He plays awful fine bass. We're awful glad to have had him put up with us today. Let's give Cuffy a great big hand. Would you do that? That's his name, Sonny. You better stand over here. He's allowed to take us and take one of them cauliflower ears off of you in a minute there. Ain't no telling. Friend, here's a tune a lot of the folks have asked for. Let me get this rope undone. I ain't ever got used to these things yet. A tune I put together a few years ago. Let's see, I don't know if you remember it. It's called "I Can't Help It If I'm Still in Love with You." Somebody else. mama's table eating some of them black-eyed peas and them hog joes or something like that. Right now, we're going to let Burrhead show his ignorance. It don't take him but about 2 minutes to get his ignorance showed, and then he quits right then and there. He did a number on the first show that a lot of people have asked for. I think we have a few of the people here that was on then. Not the first show, the second show. We didn't get here on the first show. We just plain out missed it. We'd come forward 5 miles and then the wind would blow us back 3. So we just never got here. That's just all there is to it. Burrhead's doing a little tune called Orange Blossom Special. You ready, Herman?
Always been through, so why don't you love me like you used to do? trying to find something that's false with me. Somebody's came to let me get you a clue. I ain't killed it like I used to do. I ain't had no love. I hope you're gonna kiss it in a long, long while. We don't get near it further. Push it by a country mile. So why don't you say the thing you used to say? How come you treat me like a piece of filet? My hair's still curly and my eyes are still blue. So why don't you love me like you used to do?
Child.
I could picture him while living. Curly hair, protruding lips. For I've seen perhaps 1,000 in my hurried southern trips. There rose a sad old colored preacher from his little wooden desk with a manner sort of awkward and countenance grotesque. And he said, "Now don't be weeping for this pretty bit of clay. For the little boy who lived there has done gone and run away. He was doing very finely and he appreciates your love. But his sure enough father wanted him in that large house up above. The Lord didn't give you that baby by no 100,000 miles. He just think you need some sunshine, so he lent it for a while. So he let you keep and love it till your hearts was overgrown. And these silver tears you're shedding now is just interest on the loan. Just think, my poor dear mourners, creeping long on sorrow's way. What a blessed picnic this your baby got today. Your good fathers and your good mothers tied that little fella around. In the angel's tender garden of the big plantation ground. And his eyes, they brightly sparkled at all the pretty things he viewed. But then a tear came and he whispered, I want my parents too. But then the angel's chief musician teach this little boy a song. Says if only they'll be faithful, they'll soon be coming along. So my poor dejected mourners, let your hearts with Jesus rest. And don't go to criticizing the one what knows the best. For he'll give us many comforts, he's got the right to take away. To the Lord be praised in glory forever and ever. Let us pray. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you a lot. As I said, we make quite a few records under the name of Luke the Drifter. Such songs, Beyond the Sunset. I've been down that road before. Pictures from Life's Other Side. Just Wait. It's a flopper. That's Luke the Drifter. MGM Records. 9 cents. I don't care where you buy them or not, but I strictly don't need the money no more. Good. But if you'll buy one of them and notify the folks I owe, they'll send you a congratulations card. Thank you, I guarantee you. Right now, we're going to change the tempo all the way around. We're going to pick up one of my songs that I wrote last year that got quite popular. Made me and the boys a few beans. Let's see if you remember this one. Good looking, you got the thing cooking. How about cooking it up with me, huh? Hey, hey, good looking. What you got cooking? How about cooking something up with me? Say, hey, sweet baby. Don't you think maybe we could find a brand new recipe. I got a hot rod Ford and a $2 bill, and I know a place right over the hill. That's sort of pop and the dancing's free. So if you wanna have fun, come along with me. Say, hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How about cooking something up with me? All right.
5 or 10 cents. I'll keep it till it's covered with ink. I'll write your name down on every page. Hey, good looking. What you got cooking? How about cooking something up in me?
Thank you a lot. You folks are real kind. I'm glad to see you like the high type music. I really am. I think the song that I just got through doing made me and the boys quite a few beans. Beans. And our tree, they always say that you have one song like this in a lifetime. I done had mine, I can go die now and get it over with. So. I was lucky enough with this song to get to be number one all the way across the charts throughout America. Number one on the Lucky Strike Hit Parade, number one on the Billboard Hit Parade, all of them. I mean, folk, hillbilly, race, and pop. See how many of you remember? Cold, cold heart, huh? I try so hard, my dear, to show that you're my every dream. Yet you're afraid each thing I do. Just some evil scheme, a memory from your lonesome past keeps us so far apart. Why can't I free your doubtful mind and melt your cold, cold heart? Your heart sad and blue, and so my heart is paying now for things it didn't do. In anger, unkind words are said that make the teardrops fall. Why can't I free your doubt? Melt your cold, cold heart. There was a time when I believed that you belonged to me. But now I know your heart to a memory. The more I learn to care for you, the more we drift apart. Why can't I free your doubtful mind and melt your cold, cold heart? Kindly, love sick, I mean, cold, cold heart, and hey, good looking, and why don't you love me, and it was a mess of them. They were awful good to us, but I want to sing you the one now that we've been eating awful for about 7 years, and it has really been feeding us. I don't want you to get no wrong ideas. We never did miss no meals while I made this thing and recorded it. I can guarantee you we postponed heap of them. Little tune called Love Sick Blues, huh? I got a feeling of the blues.
me sweet daddy, such a beautiful ring. Hate to think it's all over, I've lost my heart, it seems. I've grown so used to you somehow. Lord, I know I'm a sugar daddy now, and so I'm lonesome. I got the lovesick blues. Well, I'm in love with a beautiful gal. That's what's the matter with me. Well, I'm in love with a beautiful gal, but she don't care about me. Lord, I've tried to keep her satisfied, but she just wouldn't stay. Now that she is leaving, this is all I can say. I got a feeling called the blues. Oh, Lord, since my baby said goodbye. Lord, I don't know why to lose. Cause all I do is have to sigh. Oh, Lord, that last long day she said goodbye. Well, Lord, I thought I would cry. You, she got the kind of loving. Lord, I left the heaven. She called me sweet daddy. Such a beautiful dream. Hate to think it's all over. I've lost my heart, it seems. I've grown so used to you somehow. Lord, I'm nobody's sugar daddy now, and so I'm lonesome. I got to love sick blues.
Hey, y'all. Thank you. Thank you, friends. Thank you. You're awful kind. Thank you a lot. Thank you. I ain't never sung that one but 13 million and one half times. That half time was a night up in Indiana. We was playing an open air theater or something, and we was up on the projecting deal, wasn't it? And I swallowed a threatening bug about that long. So I just got about halfway through it. So we'd like to say, God bless every one of you. Thank you for coming to see us. If you come to the Grand Ole Opry, look us up. If you ain't got nothing to do, if you're walking around on the streets before Opry time, I'd appreciate it if you'd come down and visit me at my store there. I have a store at 724 Commerce Street, known as Hank Williams' Corral. You can buy songbooks, pictures, boots, shirts, hats, belts, ties. You can buy anything that I can find to sell you. Come and see us. If I can't find it, I'll send these two boys out so you can find it later. And friends, until I see you again, I'd like for you to keep one thing in mind. If you sort of follow this thought, it'll hit you sometimes, I know. Don't ever worry about nothing, because there ain't nothing going to be all right. No, you can count on that. So, good night here. Bye.
Friends, let's give them a nice hand for John Bolton tonight. Hank Williams, the Drifting Cowboys. Come on out, Hank. Let's give them a nice hand. Get them off the bottom here. Yes, sir. Thank you very much, friend. Thanks an awful lot, Hank. Friend, you've been really a grand audience here tonight. And on behalf of all the boys, Hank Williams, the Drifting Cowboys, all the fine folks who helped so much in making this big jamboree possible here tonight, all of our Rainbow Ridge Jamboree and yours truly, Randall Lowe, it's a great big thank you to each and every one of you for coming out. Be good, everybody. Good night now.